today's episode, we're going to be looking at Tender safety and security. How to equip it, how to get on and off it safely, and crucially, how to make sure that your Tender doesn't end up being one of the 3,000 or so that are currently floating ownerless around the oceans.
Having got ourselves nicely at anchor, we now need to organise the Tender so we can get ashore, or in our case, also take our shoreline. It's very useful for registering a restaurant, or supplies, or any other just little jaunts. Lots of people just zoom off in the Tender and don't cover some real simple things. We've got to make sure that we've got some means of comms. Might not be very far, but if it goes wrong, it's a very small boat. So, things I will need to have for me: VHF radio, preferably a waterproof one. Torch, great way for signalling some form of attention. Orange smoke flare, again, going to be really seen. Whistle, because it might be as simple as attracting someone. Life jackets for all on board. Might be a small little boat, but you can fall out just as easily. And then some boat specific things. We'll need a spare battery key, unless it's a pull start outboard. We'll need a spare key to the fuel, spare keel cord, because if the helm falls out, that should be round their leg, and a spare ignition key, possibly for the same reason. These little bits can go in a nice little waterproof bag, something light but highly visible is good. And then a couple of others for the boat would be spare fuel and a bailer, because there's nothing worse than sitting in the Tender and having a wet bum. On our little Tender here, we're going to put the bungs in, one either side in the footwells, put the battery switch in and the ignition, turn the radio on, attach our keel cord, and do all that before we actually launch it. So we're just going to go through the safety routine with the Tender. It doesn't really matter what sort you've got, some bits might be in yours, but there's a couple that will be on every boat. Ours got a battery start, so we're going to need a battery key. Ours has got an ignition key as well. And lastly, and perhaps most importantly, the keel cord. That's going to go round Jack's ankle and be clipped onto the switch on the boat, certainly before we put the batteries on and certainly before we start the engine. Okay, that's it. So now it's on your switch, Jane. So if you just keep going out, keep going. So now we've got our Tender launched and we've attached the painter to the cleat on the port side of the boat, just laying it gently along the stern. And Jack sat comfortably on the stern of the boat and just using his legs to position. And to get in, you just want to transfer your weight slowly into the boat so you don't tip and cause any chaos. Best technique is just slide gently in, and then as you get positioned, make your weight central. Barely a ripple. So Jane's just going to get in the bow as well. I'm just keeping the Tender alongside. Gentle transfer of weight, hand on to keep me comfy. And there we go. So Jack's here, got the keel cord around his leg, absolutely crucial. So we're just going to fire the boat up. So batteries on, please. Okay, we're going to start the engine and then I want you to pull the keel cord, make sure it stops. Okay, fire up, please. Brilliant. We've checked the keel cord. That means if anything happened to Jack and he shot out the boat, the engine will come to neutral and stop. They're off for their little sortie now. With a bit of luck, we'll get a cup of coffee and an ice cream. Okay. So Jack's just brought it gently alongside and we're now going to get Jane back out again. So we're just going to turn around, transfer weight gently onto side. Super. And again, the boat barely bobs, just keeping that weight nicely balanced. Well done.